Okay, now you know everything you need to know about making a menu and whatnot. So the basic program is pretty much over, but before we discuss advanced stuff, I wanted to take a moment to show you what your cashier's experiences are going to be like. Alright, so at the beginning of the day, your first person comes in, they have to use their time card to clock in. Alright, so they'll go to time card, they'll put in their numbers, and then they'll be given the option to clock in for the day. It'll show them their clock in time, they're all good. Then at some point in the day, they'll go on break. The computer is able to keep track of their breaks, they can start their break, and then go back in later and end their break. And then when the day is over, they can clock out. I'm not going to clock this cashier out just yet because they've got stuff to do, but obviously this is where I push for clocking out. Alright, so this particular employee is going to be the cashier for the day, so they're going to count in. They're going to hit the cashier in button, and that's going to allow them to do the money count for the day. And they select the cash tray in play. One machine, one cash tray, usually, so it'll just be the default one. Then they'll count their money. You know, this of course is more style than technical, but most people throw $100 in there in random change. You know, maybe three tens and 41s and a roll of quarters and a roll of dimes and a row of nickels and two rolls of pennies. So that's 88, so I guess I need I don't know, two more fives and two more ones just to make it better. Actually, what I would do if I were running the place is I'd put two rolls of nickels in. So there you go, $100 even. Alright, they'll finish. They'll confirm they've finished counting the money. It'll ask to print a receipt, which you want to keep track of this stuff. I don't want to waste my paper, so I'm going to hit no. But your cashier would hit yes, of course, and it would print out a receipt so you can track how much money you had at the beginning of his shift. Then to the process of taking orders. Somebody comes, they want to dine in. We didn't talk about setting up dining tables. We'll do that in a future chapter. Right now, takeout's what we got. So we'll go in through the takeout menu. And we've got all the sandwiches and burgers. Somebody comes up and says, I want a cheeseburger. I want it medium with cheddar. And I want french fries on the side. Extra tomatoes. So your cashier is either, if you bought a touchscreen monitor from us, they're using their finger and they're booping away on the screen. If you got a non-touch, then they're using the mouse. It's a little bit slower, but still doable. All right, and we go finish. All right, ma'am, your total comes to $6.75. They pay money. Cash tender is for shortcuts, you know, but settle in general will get you anywhere. We're going to hit settle. And I'm going to hear all my different payment methods. See, if I want to pay by cash, usually I want to skip the screen. And most people are paying by cash in the restaurant industry. So that's why the other button's there. So this particular customer's paying by cash. Again, for shortcut purposes, I've got exact change. I've got, they handed me $1 over, they handed me a 10, they handed me a 20. This particular customer hands me a 20, so I just pop $20. There, it tells me the change. The receipt, cash drawer pops open. I give them back their change. I print the receipt for them if they want it. And then I say done, and then we're all good. All right, some more orders come in. You know, the next person wants just a chocolate milk, a large chocolate milk, so that's fine. Total comes to $1.89. They pay by cash too, so I can pop right in and see. Cash tender brings me right in here. I don't really have credit card processing set up on this because I'm not an actual merchant, but let's say they paid by card. I could hit Visa. And instead of this, if I had a credit card processing set up, there'd be a spot for me to type in or swipe in the card, and something would pop up, and their sale would be complete. So your clerk is going through their day pretty much like that, taking money, making change. No big problems. Now let's say this person changed their mind. Oh, I don't want that milk. So they're going to go to hit void, and then they can void the line that's there. Okay. And that requires a manager's approval. So you got to get a manager to come over and put in their numbers. Make sure that that void goes through. And we'll give a reason, milk went sour. That would be horrible, wouldn't it? You'd probably be giving the customer free food and whatnot for something like that. But, you know, it happens. And, of course, I'm going to throw out my spilt milk. So now the customer doesn't really owe me anything. If the balance is zero, but we've actually put items on there, you just go to settle and hit pay. And that kind of clears that out. It's there just because, you know, sometimes you actually need to process it for accounting purposes. You know, your check is now in the system and shows that you had to throw away a chocolate milk. It's good if you're using some of the advanced inventory control features. You're counting the amount of milk you use, you're counting the amount of chocolate syrup you use, so on and so forth. So then, you know, sometime during the day, the guy shows up with the deliveries, and so, you know, like, that's why the milk went bad, because the previous day's milk was there, and that was horrible. So the milkman comes in, he says, hey, I need, you know, here's your milk, here's an invoice for $45, you need to pay me right away. You can pay him right out of the cash drawer with a payout. And then, of course, this is going to be manager approval required, but we just call it a general payment. I'm paying out to the milkman, I'm giving him $45, and new milk. Alright, finish. And then I withdraw my $45, I hand it to him, I print a receipt for accounting purposes, and then all life is good. Alright, so at the end of the day, time has come to cash out. Cash out, hit my button, this is the tray I want to cash out, shows me the time that I came in. Again, I'm going to count the money. Now, let's say that an employee, alright, we did about $10 worth of sales, so that's $110, and we paid out $45. So the number that should come out is about $65, or $75. But let's say we've got a dishonest employee, and that employee has pocketed like $25. And so at the end of the count, all that comes out is $50. Or we count like two fives and 31s. I don't know. It doesn't really matter. All right, so the end is $50. So we can say finish. The money count is finished. I want to print the receipt for accounting purposes. And now, hold on, you're short $11.75. Why? Because I have a thief. Obviously, they're not really going to write that. But, you know, your cashier is accountable if their drawer is short or over by, you know, so much. I think if it's less than $2, the screen doesn't trigger. But if it's a decent amount, the screen triggers and asks you what's going on. And then a manager has to come over and approve. Well, I was a manager that time, so I didn't have to. But a manager will have to come over and actually approve the fact that that drawer was short. So that's the way a typical day will go for your cashier. Now he can clock out because he's left for the day. And that's how the program works from a user level experience. Alright, this concludes our basic program. Next time we talk, we'll get into the more advanced things that Aldelo can do. Actually, that's not true. Next thing we'll do is talk about reporting. And the information that you can get from Aldelo about how business is going. And then we'll get into the advanced stuff.